It's my favorite time of year, holiday party season. So I wanted to make a little quick video to help you do the networking, network with a purpose, have a good time while you're at your company's holiday party. For those of you, if it will be your first time at your company holiday party, be it that you're a new hire or you just got invited, because some holiday parties are reserved for, say, the C-suite executives. So if this is your first time and you're going to be with, say, your C-suite executives, you want to make sure that you're well prepared. Find out what the dress code is. Look on Facebook, look on LinkedIn, see if you can find pictures from last year's party. So that way you're well prepared on how to dress, know who's at your table, find out how the seating is arranged. You want to kind of have some questions and, you know, filler responses in mind, because now this is a more, you know, hangout type of session. So it's not that stuffy environment. So they're going to be asking you questions about what are you going to do for the holiday? What are some of your holiday traditions and things like that? So you kind of want to have those answers prepared and ready to go. So that way you can just give them off the bat. If you're returning to your company's holiday party, try to sit and talk and meet some new people. Get to know your human resources person. Talk to people that may be a little more junior than you. Do try and talk to some senior executives. Find out about them. This is not the time, though, to find out how much you can drink and how you can eat. Definitely don't try anything new. If you know you're a lightweight and you can't hold your liquor, don't drink. Don't feel pressured to drink. Don't feel pressured to drink more or eat more and try to keep up with your comrades, because everyone has a cell phone and you might just end up the next viral sensation. And you don't want that happening. You do want to have a good time. You want to enjoy yourself. And then you're pretty much doing some internal networking. You're kind of cultivating your out of work persona, because oftentimes we don't hang with our coworkers outside of work, especially in certain settings. So you want to make sure that this holiday party, that you're showcasing the best of yourself, that you're networking, you're finding out, oh, I haven't talked to my HR person outside of this. Your CEO is going to be available, your finance person. So you want to make sure that they get to know you. And this is also something that allows you to showcase your likability, because likability is important in corporate America. So you want to make sure that you're showcasing that as well. Talk to people, relax. If you're not really a pro networker, if that's something that gives you a little bit of tenseness, definitely practice with your friends. Definitely look in the, if you can't get your friends to do that, try looking in the mirror and going over some stock answers and how you're going to introduce yourself. And this will also give you a time to see who knows you, because who's coming up to you and saying hi, who's, you know, helping introduce you to other people. So you want to be mindful of that as well. And then, of course, after the holiday party, you want to do some follow-up. Make sure you do that after the holiday party, you know, had a great time, that sort of thing. So definitely my tips that I definitely wrote down for you guys is also find out how formal the event is. You don't want to be under or overdressed. So find out what the attire is. Be on time. Of course, don't stay too late if you know that you're not a late person. Like if you get cranky once it hit a certain amount of hours, don't stay too late. You know, get in, say hi, do your little meet and greet, and then go about your day. I would also say when it's the holiday party season, it can get a little bit overwhelming. So definitely give yourself enough chance to decompress, especially if it's the holiday party is you have to go to work during the day and then the party is at night, or the work is in the middle of the day. So give yourself enough time to adjust and get your mind and body ready for the party. So let me know if you have any holiday party tips. Do you enjoy your company's holiday party? I enjoy a good holiday party. It's my second favorite season behind summer. I love the festivities. I just enjoy that time. And then for those of you who are not only going to your company's holiday party, but going to different holiday parties and you're the guest of someone, be sure to, you know, don't embarrass that person, you know, do the politeness, wait to be introduced as who you are. So that way, you know, you're going to be meeting their coworkers and things. So just be a good guest. If it's a more formal setting, go over your etiquette of salad, fork, and knives and things of that nature. Go over those things so that way you're not inadvertently embarrassing yourself and giving yourself maybe a bad first impression to some people. So just be mindful of that if you're going to be someone's guest at their company's holiday party. And in addition to that, when you're attending various holiday parties, it may not be your company's, but you just get invited to, say, an organization you're a part of, or some other networking opportunity, you know, follow the guidelines that they have set. Is there a suggested donation? Do they want you to bring a gift? You want to be mindful of that as well. So let me know if you have any holiday parties coming up. Let me know if you're excited about them or not. Have a good day. Bye-bye.